Hello again. In this lesson, we'll talk about digital language learning and its place in curriculum development. Let's begin by exploring our perceptions about the use of technology in language learning. I have some guiding questions. First of all, which one do you prefer? Face-to-face learning, blended learning, a combination of face-to-face and digital, or just digital learning? And why do you prefer this kind of learning? Second question is, what are your favorite digital language learning tools and why? I want you also to think about the role of technology in language learning. What should we use technology for? And finally, in your own point of view, what are the advantages and the disadvantages of technology in the language classroom? It goes without saying that with the pandemic that we're facing today, we all have had this new approach to using technology for learning or for teaching. So I want you to think about your own experience. How would you summarize your experience in distance or remote learning? Has it been rather positive or negative, and why? It is obvious that despite your different answers, you will all have experienced right now the use of different language learning tools. We can summarize them in three kinds: online learning, which is placing all of the learning and teaching activities on a platform or a learning management system. Another thing will be the use of different digital resources, multimedia, exercises, websites, and so on. And finally, mobile learning applications. So no matter what your experience has been, you will have approached any of these different kinds of language learning tools. Now, it is obvious that the use of technology in curriculum development and in language teaching requires to a great extent of the teacher's involvement. And that is why it is very necessary that the teachers are technologically literate. In other words, the teacher should be able to identify and evaluate technological resources. They should be able to integrate technology into their pedagogical approaches. That means that they should see what the place of technology is in every step of the learning process. Another thing that the teacher should be able to do is to design and manage language learning activities and tasks using technology. That will mean creating, editing, and publishing videos on YouTube, for example, or creating language learning tasks on Classroom, or incorporating materials and using platforms such as Moodle or Blackboard, and so on. Another important task is using research findings in the planning of the learning activities. So the teacher should also look for information concerning the use of technology, the way in which the use is more effective, and then incorporate all of these ideas into his or her teaching. Another thing that a teacher should do, of course, is to promote digital citizenship and responsibility. So it is not just about using the resources, but being able to use them effectively and also to respect, you know, the ethical guidelines of, you know, interacting in a digital world. And last but not least, adapting and upgrading to the changing digital environment. Now, the only sure thing about the use of technology is that the tools are constantly evolving, so we can easily get obsolete if we do not adapt and upgrade. Now, the use of technology in the classroom can provide very important support for the curriculum. First of all, for example, at the physical level, we need tools such as mobile phones and cameras and smart boards, among others. Technology can also provide help at the management level. For example, if a teacher has access to a learning management system like the one of Cambridge, a platform for administering the language courses, of course it becomes easier for him, for he or she, to teach and control their courses. Another important element is the applications level. So in this case, technology is going to provide software, applications, mailing systems, and chat rooms, for example. At the resource level, technology provides a great deal of authentic materials of all kinds. And of course, at the component technology level, we will have available online dictionaries, spell and grammar checkers, and digital editors for our writing lessons. In a more specific way, technology can provide a very important support for learners in their learning tasks. First of all, the learners can get authentic exposure to the language outside of the classroom. A second thing is that they can get a more flexible or customized learning experience. For example, they will be able to select the content and the skills that they need or prefer. They can also become more autonomous because using technology allows them to manage their own learning and then become more independent of the teacher. Another important support is that technology allows for more active learning because the tools that the learners will use will allow them to set and achieve their own personal objectives. It goes without mentioning that this technology can also allow the students to interact with other learners, you know, by means of blogs or video conferencing or chat rooms, and they can also get in contact with native speakers of the language. And finally, but not less important, technology can be very motivating. This means that materials that are online are more authentic than the ones that we can find in a regular classroom. There is a game-like element because all of these materials have also been designed for entertainment purposes. Now, technology can also provide a great help for the teaching task. First of all, the teachers can become more student-centered. This means that technology can allow them to focus on their students' individual needs and interests. They may suggest particular exercises or particular activities or particular tools to students with different needs and interests. They can also optimize the learning, especially when they're working with multi-level or multi-skill classes. Another thing is that they may make their learning environment more interesting, more real-world, and also have a lot of different kinds of content. Technology allows to bring the real world into the classroom. And of course, something that is very important is that technology can normally free the teacher of, you know, some mechanical and complicated tasks like writing on the board or giving handouts. If you have everything on a platform, or if you're using a smart board with just a click of the mouse, or using your technological tools, you will be able to give more interactive lessons. And of course, related to the learner autonomy, we can change the roles and we can use the flipped classroom. The teachers may assign the students some tasks that involve using technology, like looking for information or watching videos or doing some exercises, and then come to the classroom with much more information that the teacher can give. And finally, technology allows teachers to monitor and control the classes, especially if they're using a learning management system, a platform, or also something that we call computer aided language learner. That means that some particular tools that are especially developed in order to teach the language. Because of the wide and ever-growing range of tools that we can use in the language learning classroom, we need to consider some important points for determining the role of technology in the curriculum. First of all, we need to look at the purposes. Secondly, the teachers' and the students' level of technology literacy, the infrastructure requirements, that means the classrooms, the labs, and we also should consider the different resources that we have available for use. And finally, we need to make provisions for the integration of the technology with the teaching, with the learning, and with the assessment of the language. Now, concerning the purpose, I can tell you that the needs and the context analysis will tell you if technology is necessary and relevant in the program. Secondly, we need to take into account the teacher and student's profile so that we can make provisions for any necessary training or updating so that they can all become literate in the different platforms and tools that we will be using. Concerning the infrastructure, we just need to make sure that all of our facilities can be adapted to the use of technology. And of course, investment is very important for the technological resources. We need to consider what kind of equipment, what kind of materials, what kind of tools we're going to use, and see in what way they fit the syllabus and the learning methodology that we have advocated in the previous stage of curriculum development. And last but not least, we need to make sure that the technology is integrated with teaching, with the learning, and with the assessment. In this case, we need to look at the design of our learning experiences. Are we going to be using blended learning? Are we going to use the flipped classroom? We'll probably be using project or web-based learning for our students. We may also be interested in computer-assisted language learning or in the adoption of a learning management system platform, you know, like the one of Cambridge, or maybe to incorporate the use of social media into the activities. So you can see that technology will only have a role if we have considered all of these elements, because technology should facilitate language teaching and learning, not make it more complicated. Finally, as a conclusion, I want you to think about the place of technology in the era of COVID-19. It is obvious that whether we like it or not, digital learning is going to become a very important component of the world after COVID. A second thing is that the greatest challenge that we're going to have as teachers and students will be the selection and, of course, the optimal use of tools that really maximize our learning outcomes. A third thing to consider is that technology should always, always be user-friendly. That means that technology should facilitate our work, not complicate it or make it more difficult for everybody. And finally, we must keep in mind that any digital tools, no matter how sophisticated or beautiful they are, they will never replace human interaction. Digital tools remain simple tools as any other tools that the teachers or the students will use. So the important thing is not the tool itself, but how you use it. And in today's world, we need to make provisions for the use of technology according to the resources that are available in the program. So, this is what we had to say about digital language learning and curriculum development. Thanks a lot for your attention, and I will be seeing you next time.